Welcome, dear learners. Welcome again in this ARPIT course. We are here today with a very crucial topic, journal metrics. Myself, Dr. Ajay SMLT from HNB Gadwal University, welcome you on behalf of the entire ARPIT team. As a faculty member, as a researcher, we are always concerned about targeting a suitable journal for our research paper. Recently, UGC has come up with a committee, you know, it is Consortium of Academic and Research Ethics. This committee has enlisted the quality journals. But how these things are done, how benchmarking is done, this is done through the bibliometrics. Let us discuss these bibliometrics in terms of journal metrics and author metrics. As far as this module is concerned, we are going to discuss journal metrics in this module. Now let us discuss the learning outcome. After completing this module, you will be able to distinguish journals based on these metrics and to target journals based on these metrics for your research papers. We will be discussing a plethora of these matrices in this module. Now let us start our discussion. When you are planning a paper, there are two things: what and where. You want to plan a paper, you need content with respect to the what and where you want to publish it. Even when you are going for finalizing a thing, you compare the things. Even when you are going for buying even a pair of shoes, you are going to take admission, or you are going to buy a car, what you do? You compare the things on the basis of certain merits, certain facts. This is called benchmarking. How this benchmarking is done with respect to the targeting the journals? Yes, this is done on the basis of the matrices. The matrices are the benchmarks on the basis of which you select this journal is good, this journal is not good, this journal is average, like that. So, correlating what and where is very important aspect when you are planning a paper. Let us discuss need of a standard journal metrics. Why we need it? We will enlist them one by one. Number one, to assess the relative suitability of the journals, to rank the journal on merit on the basis of impact, speed and reach, to have the benchmark of competitiveness. We will be in condition to decide the competitiveness only after seeing particular metrics of journals. To have the benchmark of competitiveness of authors for assessing the researchers for the grant application, job, promotion and awards. To attract the more and more potential authors and the relevant research work. To save time in targeting the most suitable journal by the authors. Authors cannot study the several articles of several journals and spend his valuable time just for choosing a suitable journal. The metrics save the time for the researcher by helping him or her for targeting the most suitable journal. Now, dear learners, as we discussed in the beginning of this module, the bibliometrics, these metrics may be of two types, journal metrics and author metrics. Journal metrics include impact factor, ISI ranking, site score metrics, Egan factor, article influence, immediacy index, SNP, SJR, H metrics and H5, while the author metrics like H index, I10 index and G index. Now let us take the very first metrics, that is impact factor. We all are running for the impact factor. What is impact factor? Impact factor is a benchmark of reputation of a journal. It is one of the most important criteria on the basis of which we select a particular journal for communicating or publishing our research work. Now let us discuss precisely that what is the impact factor. Impact factor is a measure of the frequency with which the average article in a journal has been cited in a particular year. A journal's impact factor is presented by a digit followed by year and name of providing agency in brackets. For example, as you can see here on the home page of Expert Opinion of Drug Delivery Journal, it is written there that impact factor 5.553, copyright 2018 Clarivate Analytics, 2018 release of the Journal Citation Report. It is a dynamic index which changes on the basis of citations and number of papers every year. Now, question is, how calculation is done? In any given year, the impact factor of a journal is the number of citations received in that year of articles published in that journal during the two preceding years, divided by the total number of articles published in that journal during the two preceding years. Now, look at this formula. Impact factor year X is equal to, for example, a journal's 2017 impact factor calculation will be like citation in year 2017 from articles of year 2016 plus citations in year 2017 from articles of year 2015 divided by published papers of 2016 and 2015. So, here the impact factor of 2017 will be 4.878 by this formula. But remember, you need not to calculate these things yourself. These are the automated calculation and record which are kept, tracked and given by several agencies. And next question is, who these agencies are? Who does award impact factor to journals? Thomson Reuter, Journal Citation Reports, Clarivate Analytics, they are the most recognized agencies across the subjects, countries and institutions. ISI, the Institute for Scientific Information, ISI, Scopus SJR, Citescore, it is a different set of journal and author matrix which is given by Scopus. We will be discussing it later. Now, let us discuss indexing agencies. Indexing agencies are the organization which keep track of, keep the indexing record of the articles of the journal. If a particular journal is indexed by many agencies, it means it is the prestigious one. And when a journal is indexed in prestigious indexing agencies, there is a chance to become a journal with impact factor. Actually, the agency like Clarivate, ISI, they keep track of these indexing agencies and calculate the impact factor on the basis of that, those things only. If the journals is not having any indexing, it is not indexed in any indexing agency, then the chances of having impact factor is very rare. And don't, please, very first indexing agency is Google Scholar. You can say automated thing. Whenever an online thing comes, Google Scholar is there as a indexing agency. But automatically it is there. There is no quality output, there is no criteria there. So don't rely upon Google Scholar as a sole indexing agencies. What are these indexing agencies? Let's discuss them. Let's see them one by one. Science Citation Index, SCI, and ESCI, Expanded Science Citation Index, Social Science Citation Index, SSCI, PubMed, NCBI, Web of Science, Scopus, Embase, Chemical Abstracts, ISI, Index Copernicus, SciFactor, ICI, and at last the Google Scholar, the most widespread coverage. What I would like to emphasize upon, that the agencies like Clarivate, JCR come up with the impact factor every year in July. Say for example, in 2019 July, the impact factor of 2018 has been declared. Secondly, declaring or self-declaring the impact factor by a journal is unethical completely. So don't rely upon those Tom, Dick and Harry journals which declare their impact factors. It is just like giving awards to yourself. So avoid those kind of journals. Now let us discuss the factors on which impact factor is dependent on. After going through the basics of impact factor, let us see these factors. First is number of papers published and citations. By definition, you know, impact factor depends on both the number and citation directly. Presence in various indexing services. More indexing, higher chances of citations and hence the impact factor. Frequency of publication of journal. It is very important factor. A journal published fortnightly publishes more number of papers and hence has good chance of higher citations. Good chance of higher citations as compared to quarterly, bimonthly and monthly journal. That's why chances of getting more citation and improved impact factor is higher in these cases. Next is online nature and wide dissemination. Friends, the journals which are online are obviously more cited. The offline journals have the less chances of being indexed. Secondly, the open access journal which provide freely their access, which provide the free access of their content, they are more cited. So that's why if a journal is online available and it is open access, the chances of having impact factor is more. Then the nature of journal. If a nature of journal is review article only, if a journal is publishing review article only, or if a journal is of multidisciplinary area, then the chances of having higher citations are always there, because reviews are very frequently cited by the authors, and multidisciplinary journals have the wider coverage. They have got more readers as compared to the subject specific journals. So the number of citations, the chances of number of citations are higher, and hence the impact factor, the chances of having impact factor is more for these kind of journals. Another thing is self-citation policy by the publishers. Some of the publishers have the emphasis on the authors that they should cite some of the references from the journalists. So however, this is unethical, but the journals which adapt this kind of policy, sometimes they are having good impact. As far as I can perceive this thing, however, this is not a good thing or ethical practice. Now we come to the miscellaneous factors like manuscript presentation or editorial quality. Manuscript quality, presentation quality and editorial quality, all these three things determine the number of citations. They attract the readers, they attract the authors. So number of publications and the number of citations are going to upward trend. That's why the chances of having impact factor will be more. Now let us discuss the most important aspect. I think you might be waiting for this aspect to be addressed. This is impact factor in academic recognition. Yes, UGC has prescribed a set of conditions, API, the scoring parameter on the basis of publications. It provides certain points to its approved journal if you are having the publication in approved journal. In each UGC listed journal, you will get 8 points, and on the basis of, for each article you will get 8 points if it is a single author publication. And on the basis of impact factor, this score is augmented. How? Let's see. This pointing system, like papers in refereed journals without impact factor is augmented by 5 points, papers with impact factor less than 1 by 10 points, between 1 and 2 by 15 points, between 2 and 5 by 20 points, between 5 and 10 by 25 points, and above 10 by 30 points. Up to 2 authors, 50% of each will be given. More than 2 authors, 70-30 will be there. Main corresponding author will get the 70%, rest of the authors will get the 30%. Therefore, the higher the impact of the journal in which you have published, higher will be your API score. Now, it was about the national scenario. Now, what about the international scenario? International agencies? International agencies, they are not following the UGC rules, sir. They are just following that what kind of index journals publications you are having. They just take the SCI index journals or Scopus index journal or Web of Science index journal, or ask total impact factor of your of a researcher's profile. They don't have the time to go through each and everything when you are recruited, when they are recruiting the things, or when we are assessing the expertise. And these journals taken together give the benchmark. Establishes the benchmark of a researcher's efficiency, researcher's expertise. But don't fall in the trap of tedious journals. They sometimes, I earlier discussed, they self-declare they are imperfect. Don't go behind them, because when the agencies will track the your expertise, those kind of journals, those kind of publication in those tedious journals will be excluded. And it is happening in the national scenario even. If you apply for the IITs, you won't get any chance to showcase your TDH publications, these Tom, Dick and Harry publications, you know. So always emphasize on publishing the articles in quality journals with impact factor. And you need not to spend even a single penny, just target a journal wisely. Now let us see, if you want to verify the journal's impact factor, what you should do. Either you should have the list of impact factor issued by the agencies, or simply type the name of journal in Google search bar. If it would be there, if it would be having the actual impact factor, the Google would show in the box, otherwise not. However, it may not show you the current year impact factor, doesn't matter. Now what are the other approaches? Search individuals publishers website like Bentham, Elsevier, Springer, choose the journal from this list and then open their main page. Impact factor will be shown if exists with year and name of agency. But for other journals, as we have earlier discussed, don't rely upon the impact factor shown in their home or main page. First, check whether the journal is indexed in SCI or ESCI by checking the website of SCI, Science Citation Index. This measure is suitable for science journals, but for arts and humanities journals, SCI index and impact factor is very rare to find. These journals are not generally indexed by indexing services dedicated to sciences, biomedical, etc. And in some cases, journals are not there in English, and if exist, are not online. So in India, the UGC has constituted this committee CARE. UGC has constituted a committee CARE, Consortium of Academic and Research Ethics, to refine and strengthen the research publication in all the disciplines, in sciences, technology. What CARE has done for the sciences, technology, biomedicals, engineering, they have taken the journals which are from Scopus and Web of Science indexed. It means they are excluded from the analysis, they are taken at par. There is no question about their credibility. But for other journals which are not indexed by Scopus or Web of Science, a set of analysis is done, and on the basis of those analysis, like verified address, their indexing and their policies, editorial board, on the basis of various factors, they have approved the journals and given a list of journals. This is called CARE list of journals, and it is very important with respect to the arts and humanities, because there is actually the lack of Scopus of Web of Science like indexing, which is indexing those journals. So in the national level, the importance of indexing agencies, Scopus and Web of Science, is considered for engineering, sciences, technology and biomedical sciences. Now let us discuss limitations of impact factor. The impact factor is not perfect, but to be fair, every matrix has its flaws. Just a single highly cited article can improve the impact factor of a journal. Being a journal level matrix, it doesn't discriminate between good author, bad author, good article, bad article. The worst article in a journal has the same impact factor as the best article in that same journal. Impact factor is a slow process and does not always depict true picture. Difference in frequency and subject of the journal do not allow meaningful comparison of the journal of different subject. And lastly, there is the inclusion of self-citation, which is a problematic factor. Now we have talked about the impact factor. Now let us discuss journal impact factor quartile. We should compare the similar things. That's why it has been done. The rank order of the journal in that particular subject list and total number of publication in that particular subject list. The ratio of these things is taken as quartile, and there are four quartiles, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. So journals are placed in these quartiles on the basis of their JCR ranking. It means if you publish in a quartile 1, you are expert 1. You have published n number of papers in Q4 journals and a very few in Q1, You cannot compare those things because Q1 has got the high ranked journals in that particular list. So even the number is less, your impact will be more. So this is the way of comparison which is being practiced in IITs and major institutions, research institutions, to compare the credibility of the researchers and for recruitment process. So remember this thing also, Q1, QT, Q2, Q3, Q4. So these quartiles are very important. As I discussed earlier, you can publish without spending even a single penny in good journals. If you are not able to target the high impact journals, target the journals with good indexing. In national scenario, Indian Drugs, wonderful indexing. It is a Scopus index journal for science students, for science faculty members, science researchers. It is very good journal. Later or sooner, it is going to have a good impact. In international scenario, Current Drug Discovery Technology by Bentham Science, very good indexing is there. So target these journals if you are not able to target the high impact journals, because they are the quality journals and their future of getting impact is bright. Now, 5-year impact factor. The 5-year impact factor extends the 2-year window of regular impact factor. This normalizes the time frame limitation of standard 2-year calculation based impact factor. It is suitable for slow moving areas of research where the citation is slow and need more time. As elsewhere says, a base of 5 years may be more appropriate for journals in certain fields, because the body of citations may not be large enough to make reasonable comparisons, or it may take longer than 2 years to publish and distribute, leading to a longer period before other cite the work. These are the lines from elsewhere website. So 5-year impact factor, you can calculate, as you can see in this formula, just like the 2-year impact factor. Pros and cons are there. They are more or less same as that of regular impact factor. This gives a holistic approach and flexibility with respect to time frame, and sometime the actual picture comes with 5-year impact factor rather than the regular 2 years impact factor. You know, citations sometimes take time, and you can see in most of the journals both the impact factor are generally mentioned in their home page of the journal, 2-year impact factor and 5-year. Now let us move to the ISI ranking. Ranking of journal on the basis of impact factor. While ranking, the comparison of ranking must be either 2-year or 5-year impact factor. Do not compare the 2-year impact factor ranking of a journal with 5-year impact factor ranking of other journal. A rank should always be in context to the subject category. Within a subject category, you will have to compare the journals within a same subject category and type of impact factor. So the journals are ranked within a subject category on the basis of their impact factor. Now let us take some metrics by Scopus, cite score. Cite score metrics is a set of metrics given by the Scopus. This is a bundle of 8 metrics. What are these metrics? Cite score percentile, cite score tracker, cite score quartile, cite score rank, citation count, document count, and percentage cited. This cite score calculates the average number of citations received in a calendar year by all items published in that journal. I quote, all items. This is the beauty. It covers all the items, not only just the researcher review paper, news article and all that it covers. And cite score counts all articles as we have discussed. And it takes 3 years in count. Let's see how cite score of year 2 2015 can be calculated. Average number of citations for last 3 years, like 2014, 2013, 2012. Divided by total number of articles of last 3 years. So cite score includes all the items of the journal as we have discussed, and it is a 3-year window. In the same way, you can go through the cite score percentile, cite score tracker. Please refer the text for the elaborative things. As far as the limitation is concerned, it is not suitable for the journals which publish a lot of non-research materials, and more or less the pros and cons are similar as with the impact factor. It has also been reported to favor elsewhere's own journals over the others. It is major limitation. Next is Egan factor. Egan factor was coined in University of Washington. It is a rating of the total importance of a scientific journal. It is a count of the number of citations in the target year to articles from the, under quote, previous 5 years. So Eigen factor is based on the idea. What is the idea? Citation from highly ranked journals are more important and influential than those from lower ranked journals. It is more robust. It excludes self-citations. It is freely available. As you can see, the graph shows Eigen factor and article influence for a journal. What is article influence? It is a derivative product of Eigen factor. The article influence determines the average influence of a journal's article over the first 5 years after publication. This is formula. AI is equal to 0.01 into Eigen factor X. If AI is greater than 1, it means that all articles of the journal have above average influence. And this matrix excludes the self-citation. As you can see here, that article influence scores and total articles published for the top 25 journals by Eigen factor score in the field of neurosciences. Several prominent journals, including the Journal of Neuroscience, are labeled. The volume of each circle reflects the Eigen factor score of the corresponding journal. So what is the limitation? It assigns journal to a single category, which is very typical task. It isn't much different than raw citation count. Now moving to the next index, that is immediacy index. As the name suggests, how immediately a citation is received by an article of a journal. It is, you can say, it's a 1 year impact factor. I'm not going to do this detail, you can refer to the content. Now I will just jump to the SNP, source normalized impact per paper. The SNP measures the impact of a paper within a subject field. It is a contextual citation impact. There are two things, IPP and DCP. What is IPP? Impact per paper. DCP is database citation potential. IPP is the average number of citations received in a particular year X by papers published in the journal during three preceding years, X minus 1, X minus 2 and X minus 3. DCP is the citation potential in the subject field. It covers the relevant subject field. If you do the work on the hot topics, you will be cited normally, but the research on Raman or Pandavanrit, which is a holy dance form declared as a UNESCO World Heritage of Uttarakhand, these specialized untouched area will draw the contextual citation, and these citations are normalized as per the source in the way such that the article's impact cannot be underweight just because it was cited less. So SNP can be calculated by IPP per DCP. It is very important with respect to the arts and humanities subjects. So what are the limitations? Accurate categorization of journal is needed in a subject, and it is very typical for interdisciplinary subject journals. We cannot categorize every journal in specific subject categories. Now SJR is Simago Journal Rank. It is essentially a variation on the Eigen factor, and it is a prestige matrix based on the idea that all citations are not created equal. In this matrix, the source of the citation is weighted based on the source importance. The weighting is calculated using a 3-year window of measurement and uses the Scopus database. Citations issued by more important journals will be more valuable than those issued by less important journals. Now, altmetrix. As the name suggests, it is an alternative matrix. It is called attention matrix. The topics, the research which grab the attention have the higher altmetrix. It is attention seeking matrix. It is based on the variety of inputs. For the topics which grab the attention in social media, variety of inputs includes social medias. When a particular topic is discussed more, it gains more altmetrix. What you have to do, that you must see it in the terms of controversial matrix only, because in the controversial matrix, in the controversial matter, it is higher. It is not the benchmark of actual picture of expertise actually. Okay, it is not, you cannot use it for scholarly articles, for expert, for checking and evaluating the scholarly quality of an article. You can use it for comparing the expertise of your researcher, for comparing what projects are going well in your institution. For librarians, you can use it for comparing which journal is being cited or being referred more. So like that you can use. Now moving to the last matrix, that is H5 index. It is a journal level matrix. When at least H number of articles of a journal are cited at least H times. This is why we are taking 5, because we are seeing the 5-year window. Okay. So H5 index is a journal index which covers the 5-year span of citation potential. In a particular year, we calculate what are the number of papers which are having citations of last 5 years papers. So in this way, we can have a credibility of a journal. But H5 index, it depends upon the frequency. If a journal is having a large number of articles in a particular issue, what will happen? Its H5 index may be higher than a journal which is having a higher impact factor, like PLOS One. Have the higher H5 index than the Nature even. So this is the way it works. Now let me summarize all the things to you. So dear learners, let me summarize this module for you. Matrices are needed for benchmarking of research, researchers and journals. Here we talked about the benchmarking of journals in terms of journal metrics. In terms of impact, speed and reach, we want to benchmark the journals. Impact factor, which is a dynamic index, which increases or decreases every year, is dependent on number of papers and number of citations by the journal. Other criteria, ISI, SJR, site score, these metrics you must go through and select a suitable journal. You won't have the time to see each and every journal, each and every journal's article. Just take the help of these metrics and plan or target your manuscript for a good journal. Either target the good impact factor or the good indexing agencies. The journal which is indexed by good indexing agencies. It will save your time. So I wish you best of luck for targeting your manuscript for a good journal. Hope you might have learned some new things in this module, and I welcome you to go through the further links given in this module's text. Happy learning!